pizza. Bakit ka talaga?
Bishops present, members of the coordinating council of the Philippines conference. I thank you for this moment and opportunity to just greet and thank you for the hospitality and for all the time we have spent together. This is my second time in the Philippines, and I think and I'm sure it's not the last time. I think it's going to be the second time of the many more to come. We have come together, and the reason why I believe this is second of many times is because I believe in United Methodist Church, and I love United Methodist Church. And I believe the United Methodist Church is a denomination that is in this world to do mission and ministry to transform this world. We are a denomination that is in a world that is hating, in a world that is divided, in a world that almost looks like it has lost direction. And I think God needs us as people called United Methodists to do our part to transform this world. We have a group of several conferences concerning people about our denomination. And in this group, we meet by Zoom. And we are spread all over the world. And when I mean all over the world, it's true, we are spread all over the world. When we have our Zoom meetings, we have someone in Manila, Emma in Manila. We have two other Filipinos, one in the East Coast, one in the West Coast of the United States. A Zimbabwean who will be based in Alberta, Canada. A Congolese who is based in Nebraska. A Mozambican who is based in Missouri, and another Mozambican who will be in Kabini in southern Mozambique. In that meeting, in that Zoom call, we also have two Norwegians who will be in Oslo. And you can see we have two other Congolese, one in Lubumbashi, one in Kinshasa. As we are spread, some have to wake up in the middle of the night. Some have to wake up early in the morning. Some have to take off from their daily duties so that they can produce for our great change, the United Methodist Church. And we converse, we discuss, and we think about the future of the church, and we are concerned about the future of the United Methodist Church. We have come up with a framework which we are appealing to General Conference delegates, that all the plans that are coming before General Conference in May 2020, they have to reflect the thinking, they have to reflect the aspirations of the Central Conferences, of the Filipinos, of the Africans, of the Europeans, and of course reflecting the aspiration of our brothers and sisters in the United States. I will read the framework that we are using to look at the plans. As United Methodists from Central Conferences, we seek to build and prosper a church whose members are connected globally, to do mission together, respect contextual settings, celebrate our diversity, and value honest, genuine, and mutual anti-colonial relationships in order to strengthen our core mission of evangelism, social witness, and making disciples for Jesus Christ for the transformation of the world. When we made this statement, we consulted, and I would like to let you know that the person who finally helped us to craft it and to finalize it, it's Reverend Levi Bautista, your own son. Who are we? We are people called United Methodists. And as United Methodists, we believe we are a globally connected people. United Methodist, we are United Methodist that is represented in UMCO, who show up to come when there is a typhoon, when there is an earthquake, when there is a disaster, anywhere in the world. The people called United Methodist will show up as Kumko. Who are we? We are United Methodist with a council of bishops that will speak when one of the Filipino bishops may be in trouble with the government for being prophetic and preaching the good news. We are the people called United Methodists who were called by the General Board of Global Ministries to rally and bring voices from all over the world so that the Filipino government would let Tawanda leave and go back to Zimbabwe. Tawanda, a boy who was born and grew up in the ghetto of Sakupa. I know where Tawanda grew. And when I met Tawanda, when he arrived back home, I could see the United Methodist Church, the church I believe in, and the church I would want to see into the future. Who are we when we say we are United Methodist? Basically, a connectional project that have produced the first university graduates in many families across Africa. This is, friends, the church we believe in. And this is the church we are gathered in this room today to talk about and think about its future. Who are we as United Methodists? We are globally connected people who sent missionaries to the Philippines in 1898 and missionaries who arrived in Zimbabwe in 1897. That American man by the name of Bishop Crane Ahaso, when he went up the mountain of Chilemba, he looked down in the valley and the American man said, God revealed something to him. He said, I could see young people holding books in their hands, coming from all over the continent of Africa, speaking different languages. They were coming in quest and in search of education. That dream was fulfilled by the Global United Methodist in 1982 and in 1992 when Africa University was established to educate all those young people. And that dream today, part of that dream today, is why you are hearing this African speaking to you so far away from home. That is why I believe in the United Methodist Church. Who are we as United Methodist Church? We are the cross and flame people because we are branded from the fires of Pentecost, because that Pentecost that passed from one continent to the other. We are the flame people, the cross and the flame. We are not going to allow few people, few politicians, few bureaucrats to dissolve this denomination and extinguish that flame. We will not allow that flame to be extinguished. So the question before you, friends, when we get to General Conference 2020, the question that the delegates will be answering is, are you going to use your vote to extinguish the flame by simply adopting a plan they are calling the Indy plan or whatever other plan that they are making to dissolve this church, to extinguish this flame? No, we are not going to do that. We are not going to do that. We are calling on Africa, we are calling on Europe, like-minded brothers and sisters from the United States to support the Filipino plan that you just voted for today. This is the time when now we have this flame who will catch up more souls. This flame that is coming from the Philippines, written by a Filipino, a plan that was inspired by the statement of the Filipino bishops. Why not the whole church rally behind that? If we have to amend, we amend that plan. But we will go by the Filipino plan. Now, friends, let us go, my friends, whom I have traveled with. Let us go to the United States of America and tell everyone that the flame of the Global United Methodist Church will keep going, and let us support the Filipino plan. Next week, friends, I will go to Africa with the same message that we are supporting the Filipino plan so that we keep the flame going. Whatever you use to fire up things in the unholies, we need that fire so that we keep this flame going. Friends, we will think as the United Methodist. Let us not wait when you take that voice. It's not only a vote about the future of the United Methodist Church. It is a vote about the mission of Jesus Christ. It is a vote about future generations. It is a vote about people who still need to hear the gospel all over the world. It is a vote about those who still need voices who speak about human rights, democracy, and justice all over the world. It is a vote about the future of the world being led by the people called United Methodist Church. I'll end with a story. In July 2011, my daughter, friends, I can tell you this, if by any chance your daughter, your son, your nephew, your niece happens to be in Zimbabwe for whatever reason, and they knock at my door and they see the present man and they tell me that my parents are members of this church in the Philippines, I will do everything I can do within my power to make sure that person is safe and secure. And I expect you to do that to my daughter or to my son. This is the United Methodist I believe in. That is why we will never talk about the dissolution of this church. Whatever you do, use in your part of the world, wherever you go, this church will be there. May God bless the cross and the flame and the people called United Methodist so that we remain together in this global mission. And I thank you.
Brother Lloyd, thank you.